In 1980, U.S. soul funk nine-piece Dayton released their first of five albums on United Artists, and from it, the track Eyes on You. Okay, we're going from E to C major 7, and I love how it's maintained. Now that lead guitar part is maintaining the key of B the whole time. Na 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 na. Yeah, over the underlying key changes. Okay, I love the trade-off between the male and female voice and those flowery strings that are like interjecting on the lines. And very 1980, we've got that like slick kind of boogie funk of the early 80s in place, post-chic, but and the flowery strings as well, which harken back to the deeper disco era of like 76, 77. Love that sax. It gives it a real like late night metropolitan vibe. And that chorus with Eyes on You, I swear I've heard it maybe appropriated later on. I was revisiting this album over the weekend, I was thinking, haven't I heard this song? Like, I know it came out as a single, but it wasn't like a hit in a capacity that I'm aware of. They would have their comeuppance circa 1983, particularly on the UK charts, Dayton. But there was a commercial in the early 90s that seemed to appropriate this clothing brand. Yeah, circa like 1991. Sounds like a hit to me. Okay, we have some really great guitar bass interplay right there. I love how those like lead lines kind of flared up and that crisp bass cutting on. Touch me. saxophone solos are being played by Vince Andrews, who released a string of jazz records during the subsequent decade on Gerald Records. Yeah, his own label. Of tone right there, and how it worked with that really clipped staccato guitar that we were hearing. And a lot of people are playing on this. As a matter of fact, I imagine that the lineup here is somewhat different than the 1983 album, where they're pictured with nine people. We've actually got five main guys pictured on the back. It's somewhat confusing, the whole membership thing. Tones right there. Yeah, the keyboards of Dean Hummons, who is credited on this album with Clavinet, Honer D6, electric piano, Fender Rhodes, which we were hearing right there. He also plays Hammond B3, percussion piano, ARP, micro Moog, mini Moog, Oberheim, and Prophet 5 synthesizer. Wow, quite an arsenal. And we got another guy too, Shawn Sandridge, who is more the arranger, string horns, backing vocals, clavinet as well, lead guitar, rhythm guitar, and Talkbox on. So we've got, the Talkbox, I believe, appears on the track Living for Today. We've got so many people credited. I guess they're, the band were actually a five piece here. They were maybe a six piece on their second album, and then a nine piece on their third album. Hot Fun from 1982, and then I guess back to maybe being a five-piece in 1983 when they had some success over in the UK. And some other things, that track, I think the real power of that track was the way it held that B note throughout all the key changes. And so it gave it some consistency while also like moving around. And that locked, really tight rhythmic groove. How the strings like usurped that guitar line toward the end. Like, na-na-na, like in the beginning, it was the guitar going, na-na-na-na, na-na-na-na. And then those flowery strings overtook it toward the end, but the sax was like the real star instrument. Yeah, the sax work of Vince Andrews, yeah, quite prolific in the years that followed. Released released seven albums on his own label over the next decade. Yeah, and. What's interesting, I hadn't really stumbled upon his solo career, but his album covers have that kind of classic, like jazz album cover, almost like the 70s Pablo releases, if you're familiar with that type of photography and those fonts. Yeah, I don't know, they had a graphic designer or a visual artist or something that really gave his releases that classic jazz look. Not something you see much through this era of jazz releases anyway. That song that we were just hearing seems to have been, it must have influenced someone who did the commercial, the like 1991 era commercials to the IOU clothing brand. Because the chorus in that jingle was very similar. I got my IOU. I looked that up on like a compilation of commercials a few years ago. So. It's somewhat been refreshed in my mind. Yeah, Eyes on You by Dayton, a band named after their hometown, Dayton, Ohio, which was a funk hotbed in the 70s and early 80s. It gave us the Ohio Players. Walter Juni Morrison was his breeding ground. Let's see, the bands, the soul funk acts Sun, Slave, Lakeside, Fazo, Aura, and soul singer Leo Roberts. Yeah, quite an active musical community in that part of the Midwest, that epicenter. Anyway, let's hear another track from the first Dayton album, So Glad. Once again, the Chic influence, this time from the Chic ballad style of the late 70s. Every day I want to thank you for the loving. The hi-hat is doing the like on the twos and fours, and yet instead of doing the sliding trick of disco, it's like doing this tighter movement, like almost like acknowledging like disco is over. And the main frame of the arrangement though is guided by those like open cadence double ups between like bass and piano, very much a Chic technique. So glad I've got to love. So glad I've got to love. Diamond glissandos, diamond glissandos. And the lead female vocals are by Jenny Douglas, and the main male vocals are Shawn Sandridge.
Anytime you feel the need to call me baby, I will be.
The rhythmic component almost sounds like disco played backwards in certain places. Like instead of going, it's going like that. And the bass, instead of going do 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 do, it's going do 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 do, like up first and then like, yeah. Albeit a lot slower, so it wouldn't really be comparable to like an up-tempo disco song from like say 2 years earlier. Intense vibrato there. I like how the thickening between their harmonies and such as the music rose, the lavishness of those string arrangements filled up.
I want to thank you for the love. I want to thank you for the love.
There is something so deft about those chic-like piano arrangements where, since the piano note is doubling up like on bass notes or like hits of like the kick drum or whatever, you don't hear the actual note being played. You don't feel, but you hear the sustain of it. It's more like you're hearing sustained piano single notes through like constantly. And it creates this like harmonic effect. Other than that, just a really beautiful soul ballad with a rising chordal sequence through like some minor keys and like perhaps some major sevenths thrown in, and a lot of talent involved. Who else did we hear? Saxophonists, Other saxes credited on the album include include Mike Anaras and Mike Campbell, trombone, Ken Capel, Paul Pillar, trumpet, Jeff Park, John Hampton, Wagner, Vince DiMartino, oh, a whole load of violinists, yeah. Yeah, we had like a whole string section on that. And, anyway, yeah, Dayton would release five albums between 1980 and 1985. The first on UA, Liberty, and then the next two on Liberty. Yeah, this is being right before UA got swallowed up. And then the final two on Capitol. And two tracks were released as singles from this album, Dank and then Eyes on You, the first track in the set. Eyes on You sounding like a big hit. This too kind of like a standout ballad from the album. Living for Today being another standout track. And let's see, it says their lineup included members of Magnum and Sun. Yeah, it makes sense that there would be some crossover with Sun, given that they were like at the same breeding grounds. Yeah, Magnum being from the West Coast, and the lineup changed quite heavily between 1980 and 1985, but so did like styles. Like this catches Dayton as one of like, you could say, the vanguard of bands to take after, to initially have taken after Chic. And I don't hear really any Ohio Players influence on this band. So it just goes to show the diversity of the local music scene, local soul funk music scene, how you could have different bands coming out so different from one another. Yeah, I don't really hear like the cosmic funk elements like in these tracks, like of elements that like other bands like Sun were known for at times, or yeah. Anyway, a great time for soul funk music, and the tightening of the style and the melodic elements being accentuated in these tracks, as well as instrumental. The first track I would say emphasized like a tight groove with, you know, a catchy chorus and some instrumental excursions, you know, like with the sax and everything. And then the second track, more of a cohesive ballad with lush strings interacting with strong vocal harmonies between the two main vocalists in the band. Anyway, for more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Dayton, see the directory of albums by American funk artists linked in the description below. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the two tracks we just heard. The layers, the instrumentation, the interaction of different players, the harmonies. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-troubled trumax most, signing off.